at a disadvantage. However, so let us, without further ado, class announcements, and then we can start.
Exam,
it's open, but I will notify registration.
Father God, we just want to give you a thanks.
The exam, they know that it's...
Father God, this is a day that you have made, and we want to rejoice and be in it. Father God, as we come before you this afternoon, I pray you will continue to lead and direct. I pray, oh God, that you'll continue your way. Merciful Father, we know that it's not because of any good thing that we are here, but it's only because of you. I pray that you have blessed and kept our lecturer. I pray that you will continue to bless and keep individual in this class. Merciful Father, take us this evening as we'll continue to say thanks in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen. And thank you. And good morning again, everybody.
Evening, Dr. Mark.
Good evening from very nice...
Pleasant, no.
It's spring. It's 55 degrees. Lovely weather.
Okay, very good.
And we don't need any more sweaters or coats or heat. Thank God. Okay, all right. We apologize for the rough time. And the good thing that keep thanking Mr. Niami for his expertise in this area and for helping us. Just one or two announcements. Sent the revised group instructions presentation. It's nothing to worry, nothing major. It's just to clarify. There are some sentences I realized that were not very coherent when I read it, and one or two students had attention, and so I went and made it more understandable. So.
What's the case study?
Presentation instructions as to what is expected. Oh. I know one or two people things to my attention, and I've made some some clarifications on it. Nothing has changed anyway. The same characteristics and the format is there, but it's just that I made the things that people can, it's legible and people can understand exactly what I want happening.
So, okay.
That's not the case.
Okay, doctor.
So with that in mind, is that Monday was a holiday, is a holiday. The class, I took my holiday was Monday, and I was here, so I would, because we are winding a lot. I'm really worried about us having a lot to cover, which is very important, and I'm wanting to slip in an extra class to cover the final exam. It will be an open book exam. In a designated time. I'm trying to get the registrar, not able to get them in the registry, to send their work in that exam on this weekend and send it off for them to have an exam. And you can bring your, make certain SM5s, the treatment planners, and whatever notes you think deem to bring. Okay? I hope people are okay with that. Yeah,
okay.
Yes, we do need to catch up. This is as I said, this is a very, very important course, and it is something that we have been having with others at a disadvantage. So let us, without further ado, yes?
Have open the book in the exam,
it's
right?
Open books. I will notify registrar what the format is, all that it's open book. It's registered for 2 weeks now. I'm not able to get them. I've sent them two emails, and I'm going to have to call them.
The phone lines are down.
I know for them to transfer you.
What do you mean the lines are down?
Telephone lines.
Some very spoiled, right?
Question. The learning group case study. I know that you have the DSM-4, but shouldn't it be the DSM-5?
No, it's a mistake. That's quite it's incorrect.
That's
fine.
One.
No, we're not using DSM from it. It no longer exists.
Question two.
For what?
Please. You have two questions here. Question one and question two.
Tell me what you're talking about.
Okay, I'm talking about the learning case study. So all the questions I'm going to ask now, Dr. Mack, is pertaining to that. So I'm saying that you have two questions to answer for the case. But what it says, question one and question three. So I'm wondering.
Read the question. Read it, because I don't know. Is it the case of Justin?
No, Walker. The learning case study that we're supposed to do.
Yeah, I'm going to have to go back into that and look at that. I haven't looked at it. We need to first thing first.
Okay.
And then I will guide you as to what I expect on that one. So don't drop the gun yet.
All right. What are the primary therapies? I would like to suggest that you give us an idea of how many we should, whether it be two or three, because there are many. And we are not quite sure what it is that you would want us to. So I'm primary. And then
what happens, because as I said before, I'm going to have to really indulge you to have some extra classes to get this all in. I am prepared to sacrifice my sleep and my to do this because I think it's a very important work with teenagers and children down there. And I'm hearing I've read the newspapers in about 2 years. I don't know what's going on down there. I have no clue. But I learned that from what I heard, the Prime Minister is going to have some forum on children. So it's important that you really are able to work with children. If you can, once we get these presentations out of the way. If you will indulge, we can do some extra classes. Mr. Niam and I spoke today to see if we can, because we are behind, and I am kind of concerned about that, very, very concerned. And I like to do a good job on things. That's just me. But anyway, begin the because I need to get some lectures in tonight. Ready? Hello?
There's a slide chat from the... On the presentation, so I put a clip, a link to it.
Okay, so I can click that link. Okay.
After that, see the screen?
I can see the screen. Before we start, because we have two presentations, ladies and gentlemen, may I suggest that originally it was an hour, but right now, circumstances, we may have to cut down. You will not repeat for that. Try and see if you can make it. Up to you, but we do need to have some class time for the lecture. Is that, are we on the same page?
Yeah.
So group one comprises Mayor and Chiana. You're on the floor. Go ahead, please. Introduce yourself to the other group members. Please kindly ensure that the group members get a copy of the presentation.
Okay, good afternoon, everyone.
Okay.
Good afternoon, everybody.
Good afternoon.
My name is Sophie Mayer. I'm a part of group one. Our leader is Eileen Osborne. And we have Hello Jean Hepburn and Chiana. We're going to be presenting today family therapy. All right, Kojo, you can go ahead and run now.
Okay. Could you tell okay, I'll tell everybody on YouTube to start first. Inside here, could you please click on the link? We're gonna have to just watch it individually. Dr. Mark?
Okay.
Yes, I did. I am.
Okay, fine. Could you just click on and watch?
There is a link, Ojo.
It's in the chat. Just click on the chat link at the top left-hand corner. There's a blue icon. Some people have to mute them. I don't know.
Salvador Mnuchin was born in Argentina in 1921. In the 1960s, he laid the foundation for the structural family therapy approach while working outside of New York City at the Wilderness Voice. At the time, he worked and found that the individual psychotherapeutic techniques at the time were ineffective with this type of population. Drawing from his research at Wilderness, Mnuchin developed a structural theory that may affect these patterns have illness. In contrast to earlier theories, symptoms, according to the structural family therapy, are viewed in the context of the family's internal organization or structure. The foundation for this family structure is a set of rules the family has developed in order to function. A If a family's rules are flexible, they run the risk of failing to adapt to the ever-changing stresses of life.
No, I need you to just sit on the thing and watch it. You watch it already, so you know what it is about. Okay. Everybody else is watching. When they finish, I will need to be at the same time and we can continue, okay?
Kojo?
Hello?
Where's Eileen?
Okay. She got lost. Well, oh no. So I need to call her and try to get her back. She needs to go back to her email and try to get back in. If you call her, please tell her to do that. No. She might have had a power cut in there. Remember, she has an issue.
Let me just find out. Hello. Kojo?
Hello?
She's coming back.
Okay.
Victor?
Tracking to eliminate persistent themes and behavior patterns, and reframing to alter the family's perspective on events. All of these techniques, if used appropriately, elicit active change in the family, which ultimately helps them to relate between members and helps them to hone their naturally inherent coping skills to deal with stress more effectively as a family. Structural therapy gives the therapist a framework for understanding the unique structure of the family, meaning dysfunctional patterns in a developmental time. It offers therapists tools that can be used to help the family self-esteem. At the heart of the controversy that surrounds structural family therapy is that the approach is too aggressive and confrontational, which can cause the therapist to seem as though he or she lacks empathy for the client. This is problematic because the presence of empathy in the counseling relationship is widely considered one of the most important aspects of therapy. Critics of the structural technique more favor particular subsystems within the family structure as a result of the dependence. Also, address greater diagnostic issues and can often assume a level of competence and resourcefulness in families that may not be present. Finally, because therapists become so involved with clients during therapy, it can often result in burnout for the therapist or can cause undue stress on the family, leading to a premature conclusion of the therapy process.
Yeah, we're there now?
Yeah, go to the slide. Yeah.
You can come. So, can you close off your YouTube now, whoever is in here? I'll tell the rest on YouTube too.
We're just taking into account the
definition
that applies to people. Cultural and racial
backgrounds. Did everybody finish watching?
I'm all finished watching.
Used in a wide range of treatments, including including even anorexia nervosa, or incorporating key terms such as subsistence, boundaries, family roles, wholeness, and organization into today's common therapeutic language. Today, one can find a greater number of structured family therapists overseas where the model's popularity has grown rapidly.
Okay, can we go now?
Yes.
Go ahead.
Send up this.
The slide is up.
You're going to go to the next one now. Okay.
Now go to the third
place. Yes, it's coming.
Okay, good evening again. All right. Anorexia nervosa is a severe illness that has threatened families as it deprives its sufferer of a healthy body and mind. Many families have experienced the pain of seeing their loved ones suffer the effects of this disorder, and in many cases have been thrown into a state of helplessness. Many treatments are available. Please, they can take the form of individual therapy or change. Involved in the treatment of adolescents with the disorder has proven for young clients with a short duration of illness. Following presentation briefly at the and we look at the treatment of structural family. Now, anorexia nervosa, serious complex psychiatric disorder with symptoms which include a severe disturbance in eating behavior with the refusal or inability to make healthy body weight and an intense fear of gaining weight. Some of the disorder behaviors include unhealthy such as severe calorie restriction, food avoidance, starvation, as well as inappropriate compensatory behaviors, exercise, self-induced vomiting or laxative abuse. Individuals with the disorder may believe that weight has even in the face of underweight and extremely thin. The disorder and the purging behaviors associated with it can result in significant and potentially life-threatening medical conditions. Anorexia has been found to be more common in females than males. Clinical populations in the United States reflecting approximately a 10-to-1 female-to-male ratio. This disorder is probably most prevalent in post-industrialized, high-income countries such as the United States, many European countries, New Zealand, Australia, and Japan. Next. Next slide, please. All right, in terms of from the diagnostic criteria, the DSM-5, criterion A speaks to restriction of energy intake and that leads to a significant low body weight in terms of the context of age, sex, developmental trajectory, and physical health. Significantly low weight is defined as weight that is less than minimally normal for children, and as adolescents, it is what is minimal, it's less than what is minimally expected. Weight or becoming fat, or persistent behavior that interferes with the weight gain, even though currently low. And then criterion C, there's a disturbance in the way in which one's body weight or shape is experienced, undue influence of body or shape on self-evaluation, or persistent lack of awareness of the current low weight. Next, please. Now, we need to specify, when it comes to anorexia nervosa, we need to specify what type. So you can either have the restricting type, which is during the last 3 months, the individual has not engaged in recurrent episodes of binge eating or purging behavior. So no self-induced vomiting or any misuse of laxatives and enemas and so forth. So therefore, the restrictive type, the weight loss is actually accomplished through dieting, fasting, or excessive exercise. The other type is binge eating or purging type. And during the last 3 months, the individual has engaged in recurrent episodes of binge eating or purging behavior, self-induced vomiting, or misuse of laxatives, diuretics, or enemas. Next.
Kojo?
Hold
on, Sophie. Kojo?
Yeah, I'm seeing that they're not seen online. I don't know what's...
Okay. Go ahead, Sophie.
It's in partial remission. And when we have partial remission, what is happening? Medical criteria for anorexia nervosa. Criterion A has not been met for a sustained period of time. But either it is the intense fear, or criterion C, which is the in self-perception of weight, is still met. For full remission, after full criteria for anorexia nervosa was previously met, none of the criteria... the severity of the disorder. I won't go into all of that, but what we need to find, it's either going to be severe or extreme. And what they use is the BMI or body mass index, which is actually a calculation based on weight and height. So based on their calculations, they're saying that within these ranges that you're seeing on the screen, which is mild, moderate, severe, or extreme. Next. Are we looking at a case study that we will be treating this afternoon? Susan was a 15-year-old ninth grade adolescent with a six-month history of food restrictions, excessive exercise, and weight loss, having lost 25 pounds within the last 6 months. Susan's mother was concerned as she noticed that her daughter looked extremely pick at her food at meal times and was always exercising in her room, living room, or in the yard. Maisie expressed her concern to her husband Simon, indicating that he was not spending enough time with her. Simon exclaimed that Susan was always causing problems with her drama. Maisie then confirmed Susan explained that she was just too fat, couldn't afford to gain any weight, and needed to shed more pounds. And she wanted to be in the gymnastic team at school. Susan further explained that she wanted to be as active as her brother Samuel. Samuel, who was third junior athlete, and the family spent many Saturdays at various track meets where Samuel would be in action. In consultation, Maisie decided to seek therapeutic help for Susan. Next. Okay, at this time, Hello, Jean will be taking over.
Okay. History and background of the therapy. The treatment of the entire family being interviewed together regularly as a group is a very new procedure in psychiatry. It's difficult to estimate when exactly the family therapy was based, basically a secret movement. Therapists that treat the whole family have not published their method due to uncertainty of their techniques or fear to commit themselves to print due to possibility of heresy charges, and therefore they kept it as a secret. Few therapists practiced in quiet hotel rooms or underground because they didn't want anybody to know that they were actually doing family therapy. Until appeared on the surface in this and decided to resurface the whole thing. So what she did was did her preeminent journal of the field called Family Process. The idea of family therapy is that most human behavior is interactive. Problems can often best be helping a number of developments have set the stage for a new way of conceptualizing and working with couples and families. Take the entire family as a unit. So basically both schizophrenic and non-schizophrenic were kept and them together. Family therapy can be defined as a psychotherapeutic treatment of a natural social system the family using its basic meaning to views. In the 1950s, of researchers began to focus on schizophrenia as a possible area where family influence might be related to the development of psychosis. And some of these researchers are Gregory Bateson group in Palo Alto, California, in California, Theodore Lides group, that was in 1957, and they were at Yale, and Murray Bowen and Lehman Wayne group. There was also the National Institute of Mental Health. Next slide, Kojo. All right, so we're going to give a brief description of the therapy. Family therapy is a broad term given to a range of methods for working with families with various biopsychological difficulties. The key features used in family therapy are to know Mr. Munichin, Salvador Munichin, the founder of structural therapy, structural family therapy, and she and Millian group, who developed the strategic family therapy. Aaron developed they were the major proponents of cognitive behavioral therapy. And there was Murray Bowen, who developed family therapy, which is they otherwise call it transgenerational, or intergenerational family therapy. There is Virginia Sayre, who developed conjoint family therapy, and Susan Johnson and Leslie Greenberg, who develop emotional focus therapy for couples. Next slide, Kojo. Now we're giving a brief, description of therapy and for intergenerational approach to family therapy. His theory operates on the premise that families can be best understood from perspective, which would basically be parent, grandparent, and child, three generational perspective, as interpersonal relationships connect family members across the generation. That was the main thought behind this therapy. It proposes that each of us hold a unique set of assumptions about ourselves and our world that serves to guide us through life and determine our reactions to the various situations we encounter. Now for more structural family therapy, which is going to be our main focus, according to Griffin, the underlying assumption of structural therapy is that the dysfunctional behavior reflects structure in the family. And as said by Wichler and Hecker, it suggested that the core assumptions of structural family therapy is that all families possesses ability to change. So no matter which family, rich, lower class, upper class, it doesn't matter, they possess the ability to change. And that was the main assumptions of structural therapy. Strategic family type of behavior that is part of sequence of acts between several people and putting emphasis on the analogical in the way it conceptualized a problem. And we want to go more into structural family therapy, right? Because since we're going to be using this to treat the anorexia nervosa, we want to give a little more details about it. So it is basically approach to the family intervention that focuses on identifying the underlying patterns that are dictated space between people in relationship. Next slide, please. Now, the general assumptions of structural therapy include families are formulated in subsystem with boundaries regulating how they interact with their members, and families possess the relevant competence to solve their own challenges. And this therapy upholds conventional views in relation to the importance of power and hierarchy in the family. And they also believe that change occurs through process of reorienting the thinking and restructuring the relationship of the family members. Next slide, Kojo. According to 2008, the main therapeutic technique techniques of structural family therapy are joining and accommodation, and this is basically forging and maintaining therapeutic alliances with the member of the family. So it's kind of getting the family to become comfortable and getting to know them as individuals and as a group. Enactments, this is where the family is basically asked to do a role play based off conflict or some sort of dysfunction that they have that has occurred in the family during the therapy session. Structural mapping, this is where the therapist is using this technique to identify the types of boundaries, transactional styles, and subsystems to determine desired change in the family. Now there's highlighting and modifying interactions, and this is inquiring and observing how the family members interact with each other, pretty much. So they use this to see how they behave towards each other. And there is the boundary making, where realigning boundaries by a softening rigid and strengthening diffuse boundary. So they try to ensure that parent is not too rigid towards the children or too diffuse, because they want them to be at a midpoint. And there is the unbalancing, where this ties with one person to break a stalemate in the family, and the therapists tend to do this. Next slide, please. Now the use of therapy, of the family therapy. Family therapy was used to treat Susan's disorder of anorexia nervosa based on the premise that there are interactional difficulties between Susan and her family. According to the case, Susan's disorder is a precipitating factor which was triggered by the lack of attention from her parents. Now, the approach used in family therapy, as we stated before, family therapy, as this model was subscribed by Munichin for treating anorexics. Now, anorexia nervosa is best approached through a therapeutic focus on the structure of the patient's family, as this disorder is associated with characteristic of a dysfunctional family pattern, which was basically displayed within this family. Treatment should be directed to restructure the dysfunctional family system and replace them with more adaptive patterns, not to promote psychic change at all. Now, therefore, the entire family will be seen together often for the whole treatment period, and a planned therapeutic intervention will be done to induce change within the family as a group. So I'll now move on to goals and objective.
Sophie.
All right. Okay, just before we go into the goals and objectives, we would just like to say that in treating anorexia nervosa, the very first thing that needs to be done is to find out whether or not the client needs to be hospitalized. All right, but we will not be focusing. Also, we would like to state that in many instances in treating anorexia nervosa, even if you do use family, also used in conjunction with individual therapy, the client that has the anorexia, we will not individual family therapy. We lost our information, Kojo.
Kojo.
Yes, I'm trying to, I don't see, one moment. Okay.
Does anybody have any time?
Dr.
McKenzie. Let's ask time until he gets it up. Okay. Go ahead, I'll keep reading.
Okay. Just give me 2 minutes.
Okay.
Okay. Could you go Go back up, Kojo.
Okay.
Right, thank you. This study used and met criteria for reproductive type. The family dynamics gave some indications as to a dysfunctional family system. Boundaries between father and daughter were rigid, and the relationship disengaged, as father tends to pay less attention to his daughter. Boundaries between father and son were diffused, and the relationship enmeshed. The sibling subsystem seemed less than ideal, as Susan and Samuel did not seem to be close. Next. The parental subsystem was not functioning effectively, as father and mother appeared to have different concepts to their children. Spouse function effectively in disagreement. Father has developed a coalition with his son, while mother seems to be aligned with her daughter. Susan is being blamed for causing disruptions in the family with her eating problem. Next. Now, in treating anorexia nervosa, there are some long-term goals that need to be achieved in order for the disorder to be in full remission. These include restore normal eating patterns, healthy weight maintenance, and a realistic appraisal of body size. Stabilize medical condition with balanced fluid and electrolytes, resuming patterns that will sustain life and gain weight to a normal level. Next. Develop healthy cognitive that lead to positive identity and prevent a relapse of the eating disorder. Develop healthy interpersonal relations to alleviation and help prevent the relapse of the eating disorder. Develop coping strategies, example, feeling identification, solving and assertiveness to address emotional issues that could lead to relapse of the eating disorder. Next. Now, because we recognize that this is a family dysfunction, we also need to set some goals for the family. As a family in therapy and specific to the case, the following goals and objectives need to be met. Clear boundaries between all subsystems for connectedness and differentiation congruent with the family's cultural context. Clear distinction between the multicultural subsystem and the parental subsystem. In other words, what the society expects and what the culture expects in terms of your thinness and so forth, as again, the parents and the family say. Effective parental hierarchy and the severing of all cross-generational coalitions, and that promotes the development of individuals as well as the family. Next. So because we're dealing with family therapy, we're going to be doing this treatment in three phases. Now, in first phase, in this phase, the therapist will take a history of the eating disorder. After taking the history, we also want to place parents in charge of weight restoration. So in the first phase, it is not the client that will be responsible for gaining back the weight on their own. It is the family that is going to ensure the client is eating properly. Note patterns. The therapist will note patterns of eating and the compensatory behavior of the identified client. Establish healthy weight goals, so in accordance with what a teenager her age and so forth should be, that is the weight goals that we're going to be looking at. Establish with a physician a minimum daily caloric intake for the client. Implement meal planning. Consult with a physician if fluids and electrolytes monitoring. Provide suggested reading about the disorder. In this phase, the therapist will use the technique of joining and accommodating to build rapport and assist each family member to feel accepted and understood. Specific techniques within the joining and accommodating that will be used are reframing, which is attributing a positive intention to behavior, tracking, using language idiosyncratic to the family, and meniasis, matching the family style and tone. So while the therapist is looking at the interactional patterns, for example, listening to the family, he's getting that back in his own tone and so forth. Further techniques will be used to bolster parental authority, addressing parents, for example, more formally than their children. In this phase, each family member will share his perspective on how what they perceive Susan's state of ill health, what needs to be done. The therapist will attempt to raise the parents' concern about Susan's condition as much as possible. This is done so that they can be mobilized to take charge of Susan's eating to promote weight restoration. The therapist will also reflect the family's comments back to them in such a way that it amplifies the seriousness of the problem. Note that goals of treatment will be discussed with the family. All right, so as I said, in phase one, the main thing is to discuss the goals. You're going to be monitoring the weight. The parents will be put in charge of restoring that meals. Each person gives their idea of what is happening and so forth. Okay, in the second phase of treatment, which is really your working phase, in this phase of treatment, the techniques that will be used include structural mapping, boundary making, highlighting and modifying interactions, enactments, and unbalancing. We're going to focus on three main ones. The therapist will weigh clients and enter information on a weight chart to see if caloric intake goals are being met. And this is done at every session. Therapists will also continue to consult with the physician as necessary. As progress is made in reaching weight goals, the family will be congratulated. Next. So with the enactment, this involves allowing family patterns to emerge. But with the therapist pushing for a different outcome in which parental hierarchy is, role play will be used to discover the interactional patterns between all members of the families, as well as to practice boundary setting. A key element here will be to remove the blame from the identified client and spread equally by demonstrating each person's action contributed to the problem dynamic. Next. Boundary making. This technique aims to reinforce healthy boundaries between the generations. This will involve strengthening the diffuse boundary, flexing the rigid boundary between father and daughter, disrupting the coalitions between mother and daughter and father and son, and aligning the sibling subsystem where Samuel can provide support for his sister Susan. This is very important because the parents have been put in charge to ensure that Susan is eating. She's going to be resistant to that. She's her brother while this is taking place. Unbalancing, from time to time, it will become necessary for the therapist to join with a family identified client who is engaged. So Susan is being blamed for being a drama queen, so the therapist might have to join with her from time to time. In the final phase, family and therapist will develop a list of high-risk situations for unhealthy eating and weight loss practices. We also learn and implement skills for managing urges to engage in unhealthy eating or weight loss practices. Application of strategies. Thoughts, images, and impulses that can precipitate uncontrolled behaviors. In managing urges, client will be taught relaxation techniques, self-talk, distraction, conflict resolution, among other techniques. Therapists will develop a maintenance plan, not just with the identified client, but the family, which describes how clients identify challenges and high-risk situations. I referred to an eating disorder support group. It will be terminated after completing the three phases. An identified client's weight has been stabilized. The client of choice usually, anorexia nervosa is predominantly diagnosed for females, approximately 90% between the ages of 14 to 18 years. Therefore, the clientele of choice would most likely be a female within the age of 14 to 18 years. Clientele of choice would be living at home with their family and has met the diagnostic criteria for anorexia nervosa next. And the family system would also be dysfunctional in that there is evidence of rigid or diffused boundaries, relationships are enmeshed or disengaged, hierarchy is ineffective, and there are cross-national coalitions.
Okay, I'll pick up from here.
Yes.
And we're looking at the effectiveness of the treatment intervention. And we're saying the theoretic foundation, as Monachin and his colleagues found, anorexia is linked to dysfunctional familial patterns. And guidelines strongly suggest family therapy to treat children and adolescents who suffer from anorexia nervosa. And this, the structural family therapy is tried and tested empirically. And it suggests that family therapy is often used in clinical settings to treat anorexia nervosa. And family therapy adequately treats adolescents who suffer from anorexia nervosa for less than 3 years. And that is important for us to know. Next slide, please. Normal weight and functioning for the majority of adolescents, the short term, that is below 3 years. And then there is enduring benefits surpassing 5 years after they have been treated with this intervention. This family-based approach provides and allows family to change while retaining its autonomy. The research shows that in most cases, the clients recover without having to be hospitalized. And I want for us to note that research indicates that the family therapy is not effective in adolescents who had the illness for a protracted period, that is over 3 years. So it's mostly treat persons who have been under 3 years. Effective for children or adolescents early on while in family settings. So while they're living in their family settings, when the treatment is this intervention their situation. All right, it is able to identify characteristics common among families. Focus on family, not solely the individual. It proved successful as a treatment, and as you would have seen, it can apply to cases where we applied in our case study, and it can be applied to various psychosomatic illnesses. All right, so in lieu of time, we'll move on to the next slide. Advantage and disadvantages. A clear model for therapy. It has clearly stated goals and targets, recognized and described, utilizes tried and tested change techniques, effectiveness of method validated by research. Relatively simple, solid, and direct, the technique forms a good basis for persons practicing family therapy, and it for example, take something as abstract family and organize it in concepts such as boundaries and hierarchy. And the approach is versatile difficulties. The disadvantages, in addition to those that we saw, if they're simple, you know, if we don't know to apply this correctly, then you know, we can deceive as how simple it really is. So it appears deceptively simple. Before having enough grasp of family rules, constructing too early, the process must be followed. All right, imposing the therapist's solution on the family can be an effect when applying the rigid blueprint of family functioning. The theory operates under the assumption optimal family hierarchy is that of two parents system, and we know that is not always the case. Okay, next slide, please. Disadvantage: lack of cultural awareness, in that for example, enmeshment and disengagement disregards parental techniques of other cultures. Healthy boundaries can be problematic for cultures with less distinct boundaries within the family. Involve only reconstruction techniques, and the technique does not have a strong theoretical background, and it focuses only on impact of the social context. Next slide. In terms of the training for the family therapist, it is important to look on the function that they on their function. So they have four functions basically, and those functions are the problem. So under engagement, professional for the family approach, establish positive relationships, convey professional community and therapeutic family alliance. Under their problem identification, there is need for to clarify the presenting problem, focus on the immediate process, identify and explore interpersonal problem, clarify individual problems, and integrate the assessment. On function as change facilitator, there's the need to break maladaptive interaction patterns, clarify problematic consequences, emotional blocks, reconstructing, implement new adaptive patterns, mobilize external resources as required. For example, if the client needs to be hospitalized for the anorexia nervosa. All right. In terms of their function to terminate the process, this must be done properly. They must assess family initiative to terminate. When there's an indication, then they must terminate the initiative termination, the initiated termination, when it is indicated by the family, and they conclude the treatment constructively so that the family can, if they have further issues, when they work through themselves. All right, in terms of skills and training requirements, and Levin, they are saying that when a family therapist is being trained, then they must be trained to set objectives. So very important for the family therapist. Right, they must be specified. The objectives that they set must be specified in behavioral terms to ensure clear expectations and progress can be readily assessed. They must have perceptual skills, and this is used in individual diagnostic assessment, plus emphasis to the perception of interaction and the meaning and family members and system, and they must have conceptual skills, that is the ability to formulate one's observations of the family as a whole, or behavior and dynamics. Executive skills, that is the ability to influence the family to demonstrate the way it functions, series of transaction, so as to alter the way it functions. And they must have collaborative skills, and because they must have good interviewing skills in order to develop collaborative working relationship. And out of this, they will form the therapeutic contract. And these skills are necessary in a family setting where there is usually a lot of disharmony. All right, so Sir Victor will take over now.
The next slide. Looking at the duration of the therapy, it has been observed that beginners see the patterns of family dynamics. Even though structural family therapy offers such blueprint in three constructs, namely structure, subsystem, and boundary, it is important to note that Monici's recent work, that is his recent work on assessing couples and families, he brought another spin to what structural family therapy is. Within this pilot, he described a four process of creating a family therapy, which he looked at in four dimensions. First one, the customer always right. This is to challenge the family setting that the primary problem is located of the identified patient in the process of probing for questioning. The supporting task. This is to explore what family members may be doing to perpetuate the presenting problem. Stage three, the specials. This is to explore past experiences that may organize family members perpetuation of the identified with the presenting problem. And stage four, new beginning. The purpose of this is to explore what the family members are willing to do in order to make productive changes. However, Monici continued to emphasize the need for structural assessment, the use of enactment, and working with experiential intensity. Therefore, structural model has evolved to include what greater emphasis on cognition and insight. Next slide, please. Another variation on the technique is ecosystem structural family that is systemic, strength-based, and trauma-informed family therapy model, which has evolved from structural family therapy. Children and adolescents with severe emotional behavioral problems and their families in an outpatient setting. From using structural family therapy with families that not with anorexia nervosa, according to Duke Sandstorm, he shows that families as structural family therapy can be effective and their families. For instance, based on his research, he combines family therapy with a family placebo condition and individual therapy. He discovered that symptom reduction was significant with structural family therapy. So the level more than double in the other condition, and this was within 6 to 12 month period. It is also noted that recently studies have shown that structural family therapy can be effective when addressing problems and the externalizing spectrum. For instance, disruptive behavior, adolescent substance abuse, personal disorder, attention deficit, hyperactive disorder. And also, studies also have also showed that structural family equals ineffectiveness to communication training and behavioral management in reducing negative communication conflicts and expressed anger between adolescents that night with attention hyperactive disorder and next slide studio. Applicability diverse population within the Caribbean. There is a substantial body of research demonstrating structural family therapy success in treating a wide variety of clinical problems. This includes adolescent and family-related issues. According to Swain Martins and Abel, 2010, eating disorders are in non-Western cultures, resulting from media exposure. This is also true for the Caribbean. Next slide, please. Roger.
It's here already.
Okay, in Jamaica, current research shows the presence of this disorder in low incidence, affecting mostly students in the urban. That is of low energy intake in the Jamaican society is more attention, weight, and food. a compensatory mechanism to manage upsetting and difficult emotions in order to have a sense of control over one's life. Next slide.
Go ahead. Go ahead.
All right, sorry. It is according to CLO 2005 report, concurrence with other females, adolescents usually have better body image perception than their white counterparts. This may be explained by information provided in literature, which suggests that black women are less likely to try to lose weight based on the notion that black men prefer blue body or fluffy women. At least we know that in our context. Continue. Next slide, please. It is therefore important also to note that the Caribbean, particularly the Jamaican context, is described with respect to the meaning of family, parenting, and psychological family ties. In addition, childhood and disturbances that affect the Westerners are common within our context equally. As mentioned, structural factors that is proven to deal with childhood and adolescent related disturbance, it is therefore true to say that the therapy can be applied in the Jamaican context. For instance, in the video with the Jamaican street boy that was shown in the class recently, we note where the mother had the same carefree attitude as son. Therefore, we recommend that structural family therapy will be suitable, a suitable intervention for such family, for that family. And also we believe that the family system would benefit as well as the individual member from. As we looked at structural family therapy, we looked at biblical particular approach. We discovered that the family therapy focused on family as the unit for therapy. As such, perceptive is what somewhat consistent with the Bible emphasis on community and body life of the church, including a healthy family life. References are there. The systemic focus of therapy on the family can nevertheless be overemphasized to the point where the personhood of the individual or family member. Paradoxically, the Bible also emphasized the what and personhood of the individual human being who is deeply loved by God. Reference also is there. As such, the Bible retains on the individual as a special person created in the image of God. Also, family therapy pays other contextual factors such as social, political, economic, religion, spiritual, and other environmental factors that impact family life. This with the Bible, such as the church as the body of Christ, or the kingdom of God, wherever and whenever, and in whom God rules and reigns. Family therapy is focused on the family function, family relationship, family identity. This also is consistent with the Bible themes of function, relationship, image of God, or image of the day in which human beings are created. I turn over to my colleague.
Conclusion. Anorexia nervosa can be treated through individual or family therapy, but we chose family therapy. Structural family therapy empowers family to solve problems within a group. So as a group, they're able to solve everything together, all their problems. Now, family therapy found to be adequate to treat anorexia nervosa, according to Minuchin, as we stated before, with cultural awareness and experience, structural family therapy is greatest disadvantages. And anorexia nervosa is not pervasive in the Caribbean. The therapy is in accordance with the Bible and in focus of structure, and in focus of structure, etc. But it lacks individual element that is sometimes necessary. There comes the end of our act or presentation. Is there any question?
The next slide, for you.
I do have a couple, but I have a couple questions and a comment. Okay. But let me open it up to the people, the people who are on one or two on the chat and YouTube, the YouTube. Are there any questions of group one, please? Group two, no questions from group one. We're live.
No questions for me, Dr. I'm here, but what I believe in well-researched presentation. Congratulate them on their presentation this evening.
Okay. Are there any questions from this? We while group two starts preparing for questions from
Robert says, well, Nordia says,
I need to say it. I'm not saying I see it. Can you paste it, post it rather, please? Good. Okay. Any other questions from anybody before I ask one or two couple questions that I need to ask? I tend to tell people that it has been a well-researched presentation. With in terms of integrating a lot more with the in terms of seeing how the Suzanne and her family are benefiting. For example, how would they deal with the boundary issues in terms of how does the mimesis work, and the structural therapist, and particularly Mnuchin. One question I would like to ask, and that I'm recording my head. One is, there was reference to the applicability in the Caribbean and Jamaica, and reference to the fact of adolescents, the differences. Now, what is the main, what is the distinct difference between adolescents in the Caribbean, Jamaica, States, or North America? What's the distinct difference? In other words, what other disorder that I didn't see you bring up? Not necessarily in terms of equivalent of what exactly is a true AN, anorexia nervosa. What's the difference of how teenagers deal with eating problems in the Caribbean? Can anybody answer that? Go back to that slide about the applicability, and it talked
Dr.
about
Dr. Mark,
yes.
Dr. Mark, if I remember vividly well, they mentioned that the way body, the way the it is viewed here, their body image, they have a positive perception of touch.
Yes.
That's not much a problem here in our context.
Mm-hmm. What could be, okay, go ahead.
The positive perception they have towards their self, I think that's the reason why they are able to, you know, contain that threat.
So how do they deal with the disorder? What other disorder in the DSM-5 could you use to say, okay, the teenagers are in the Caribbean context or Jamaican context. What is, they're likely to try to lose weight based upon that black men prefer full body. So, what would be the underlying driving psychiatric dynamic that would make teenagers have problem eating disorders or eating problems, I should say? Disorder, or do they have something else?
Dr. have something, just I cannot pin my finger on that specific time. Something that is somehow related.
Okay, well, I wanted you to talk about binge eating disorder, which is totally different. You know, it has a derivative, but it's a derivative of both anorexia and
eating disorder,
and bulimia. So in other words, we can argue then, can we not argue that kids do not necessarily have an eating disorder? Or do they have a body dysmorphic disorder? Do they have a binge eating disorder? Can you say that? As opposed to what's driving this kind of behavioral phenomenon? As opposed to teenagers in North America who starve themselves literally to death because they think they're too thin. What's driving it?
Doctor,
bleach.
Yes.
In the Caribbean, that's a general given. We love food. I don't think that teenagers necessarily through eating that much. It's expressed in other ways. But not in terms of eating disorders. We don't do that much here.
Mm-hmm.
Our teenagers tend to express it in conduct disorders, exactly. Low self-esteem, stuff like that. But in terms of our eating, I don't really see where our teenagers express their emotional distress eating disorders.
Here in the Caribbean, in Jamaica especially, we bleached. When we dissatisfied with our body, then we do bleaching the skin.
I don't know if
that has anything to do with.
And Sophie, Dr. Heather Littlewhite, well, I don't know if she's still alive, but she has a piece that a lot of. She's alive?
Yes.
No.
Oh, she died?
No, I think she
died. She had done a piece on, she actually was saying is her parents don't really recognize it as such. When the children are acting out in some other ways that you might mention there, and they come to see her, she would recognize that that is a situation. So again, it probably comes back to the point that it's not properly diagnosed and reported as such.
So they are incidences of where people manifest emotional distress through binging, but the culture does seem to, in other words, there is a, what it seems then is that there is a cultural paradigmic shift in how people, teenagers express themselves in that, in Jamaica. Just reading some of the comments from people, I don't want to leave them out. In the Caribbean, there's a culture of being fat or fluffy. That's from Nordia. In the USA, the image is more negative, where slimness is idealized. There are popular Jamaicans that bash slim women, calling them crumb. What?
Interesting.
Interesting. I'll have to Google it. that they have blue bone, or them starving or in the words, you can look at the phenomenon but it seems to suggest that there, as someone said, as I think Michelle Williams said, that there probably is eating disorders, but it's really probably not defined and understood so much as in North America, where people literally starve themselves to death. I mean, they have an eating disorders clinic because it's an epidemic with white Caucasian females. I also see there is likewise songs that exalt the bigger bodied woman, saying that they're healthy. Yes. Lastly, I wanted to also comment. You mentioned also about one of the variation of treatment that it treats psychosomatic illnesses. You didn't say what type of psychosomatic illness it treated. I didn't want to interrupt you. What does it treat? What psychosomatic illnesses does it? That is it good? Is it relevant for?
question is that, Dr. Matt?
There was an issue about that talked about psychosomatic illnesses, and I didn't want to interrupt you, so I didn't tackle it right there. It was what?
I think it's under variations.
Under variations. Okay.
Yeah, but what type of psychosomatic illness? Give an example of that.
No, I don't think anything such thing was here in.
I saw it. It's there. It's in there. It's in the body. But okay, anyway, we won't belabor the point. Are there any other questions? Just that, like I said before, how would you use? Take us through briefly how you take. How would you work with her? How would you join? How would the therapist join to the three phases of the structural family therapy with Suzanne? You're using this family system. You're right to refer her to an eating disorder group, which is excellent. But how would you haven't stated very definitively how the therapeutic methods would be used in working with the family for them to,
When the family, let's say for the from a sort of medical perspective, there's information that will be gathered in terms of Susan's eating patterns, what are patterns in terms of exercising and so forth, in terms of the joining and accommodating. This will do is that he will get a person, he will engage each family member for them to say, okay, what are you seeing in the home? What is happening? And then each family member gets to tell their side of the story, basically. With Susan, she will tell her side, then, and Samuel. So,
and that is, and really be in order for everybody to be feel comfortable so that they don't feel as if you're taking sides with anybody. You try to get details of what's going on, how each of them view the problem that exists in the home. That's the joining and accommodation.
Okay. How different would that be from Jay Haley's strategic family therapy? Because you mentioned about me from Jay Haley's strategic family therapy. I want to belabor this.
In strategic, Dr. Mark?
Yes.
In strategic, the therapist takes control of the family intervention. Let me put it that way. So the therapist is the one that directs. The therapist is going to now issue instructions as to what is to be done. So the therapist will devise a plan and then give instructions as to how the plan will be enacted. Well, enacted is a structural word, but how the plan will work in the home. So he will give each family member specific things to do. So the therapist is the one that brings the plan and then tells each family member what is to be done.
So then the strategic basically Sophie give the instruction, while the structural try to get a little background from each family member of in regard, pretty much.
So basically, how would a family therapist deals with specifically with Susan's eating disorder? How would they deal with it?
Well, Dr. Mack, you know, the main focus of structural in terms of dealing. Mm-hmm. Is that they are, first of all, they are trying to basically restructure the family. So, for example, the boundaries, the various boundaries. So, in terms of how the father interacts with the son, as against how he interacts with the daughter, they're going to realign those boundaries.
Yes.
Because what they're saying is that those boundaries are not cleared. It's either rigid or diffused. They're either enmeshed or disengaged. He structure the dynamics of the family, and in so doing, change the hierarchy where, for example, the son is no longer almost the focus of everything, you know, hierarchy now. So the parents, will sort of take charge of Susan's, at the start, take charge of her eating thing, ensure that she eats, and become the parents, basically. That's what the therapist.
Yes. Okay. All right. I think basically you have you have my question and seem to have had a grasp of both techniques and use them wisely. So I will not belabor the point again. We will want to thank you very, very much for a well put together, excellent presentation.
Just before you run out, the psychosomatic illnesses.
Yes.
I think an example could be like anxiety or depression.
But that's not psychosomatic. Psychosomatic is something that is no, psychosomatic illnesses are illnesses that don't seem to have they don't really have a clinical cause. They are more based upon a functional cause. In other words, like a psychosomatic illness would be an illness
Disorder would be one.
Yeah, it's more symptom related, where the person is more having for example, they may have they may have aches and pains, whereas chest pains, whereas there is no real medical cause for that. That's a psychosomatic illness. Oh. How the treatment would have worked with that. I'm not saying that you're incorrect. I'm just saying to identify exactly. All right. Yes.
I have on YouTube are having challenges every now and then. They get kicked out. But it's just to inform you.
Okay. Well, I'm sorry. Mr. Naomi, are we able to be kicked out? I don't know.
I'm not sure either. It's just that to try and assist because I have to be read. So I couldn't really try and assist, but I kept sending the link back
to
them.
All right. I tell you what.
Were not able to get back.
Okay. Can we start now? Group two. Yes.
What I can suggest, which is what I did, could group two just email them the PowerPoint that they have to present, so at least they can try and follow.
Yes, I suggest that's an excellent idea. That's, could group two take the time out now? You're now on the floor. Please take the time out. We're gonna take a 2-minute break, and I need to replenish myself. I want to keep awake, but could you start sending the YouTube people the presentation? While he's putting that on to be left out of the class. So can we take a couple minutes, 2-3 minutes?
Okay, Dr.
I'll be back shortly.
Okay. Yes?
Okay. Are you okay now? You okay now?
We're okay because we've gone through
to everybody in the groups. Just choose one of those emails that was sent to you by to everybody and just reply to all and just send it. Or you want me to send it?
I realize.
Yes,
Michelle.
Yes, Victor.
Yeah. It's going to do overwhelmingly for you people. So, at last.
No, man, we are right, you know. We are right. Thank you.
Marlene.
Yes, Victor.
Yeah. Yes. Don't relax. Okay?
Yes, Victor.
The hand of
God has been good to us. It's been good to us, and it's going to continue being good to us. You guys were great. You guys were great.
Definitely.
You
know? So.
Yes, you did.
Rename it.
Here am I.
Okay.
Yeah, I'm here, and I'm online.
Okay, wonderful.
But it says live.
Hi, Latoya. Latoya.
Hi, I'm here.
Good.
Trying to be.
Okay. All right, Rena. Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Yep.
Oh, Marlene. I was calling Eileen. How you doing, Marlene?
Oh, you're the, okay. It's all. I'm good.
Sophie.
Yes, hello. Congratulations to you, my. Yes.
You need to bubble up.
Yes, Victor.
You need to.
Okay. Be back. Michelle, did you send the did you send that thing to the students by YouTube?
I just sent them.
Okay.
Coach, just sent it for me, Doctor.
Okay. All right. Are we ready to begin for our group two's presentation?
Are you seeing the thing?
No, not yet.
Okay, it's 10 o'clock here by my watch. I'm not certain we can get that lecture for. I'm not certain, but we'll do it anyway. Are we ready for group two's presentation? No.
The presentation is up?
Yes, Michelle.
Yes, I'm not seeing it. Where do I go to see it? Oh, I'm seeing it. That video is not supposed to be played now, Kojo.
There's no video.
Oh, okay. I thought I heard something.
But
sorry.
Okay. You do have a video?
Yes, it's in the piece.
Oh, it's not going to show unless I have it before. I need to have it so that I can, because it's from the piece.
Okay.
Where is it? Which
Go down in the slide and you see.
No, I need somebody to send it to me from the
piece. It could be on slide number 4.
Yeah. Let me.
It's all right. Don't stress yourself. It's okay.
No, I'm just going to go down. Sure.
Unless you can take out the link and put it in YouTube. I'm just bringing it to the link. Because it's actually a YouTube
link. Let me just do that.
Okay.
I'm going to have to let everybody watch again because I don't think it's going to allow us. So when you reach the real part. When you reach on YouTube, just hold on a minute. Let me just pause it.
Okay.
And I'll copy the link so that I can, so others can see it.
Okay.
The person on YouTube have gotten the PowerPoint.
Okay, thank you.
Welcome.
They can click on the link when they go to. I am not sure they will do that. But I'm going to send them the link anyway. I try to send the link to YouTube first. So that they. Okay, let's go now. Let's see. Let's go back.
While we're waiting, let me just
Okay.
Go ahead and start. No, time is
Hey everybody. This is group two's presentation. Before I start, I'd like to make a proviso. First of all, Dr. Mack. We're doing transactional analysis, and the TA is an official citation for transactional analysis. So sometimes you might see TA versus all of transactional analysis.
I'm glad you alert me to that. Thank you very much. I appreciate that.
And the other premise I'd like to make is that we actually approach this project from looking at treatment intervention.
So you're not going to be hearing a lot about the disorder that we chose. The disorder that we chose is going to be there to be used to show how the therapy can treat that disorder. So the criteria that you're going to get is not going to be a fulsome criteria. It was supposed to be brief. But the what you said today was saying something different. So I'd just like to make that comment as well.
Well, so like I said, well, basically what I said before, that the in terms of the presentations, that the original instruction stood, it's just I made, I wanted to make, to clarify some of the incomprehensible. So I don't think anything is going to change for any group. So nobody will be at a disadvantage. As long as people follow the standard guidelines, I have no problems with that.
All right. So seeing that it's not a psychopathology class and it's a psychotherapy class, we're actually focusing more from the psychotherapy. So we can begin our culture thanks. So members are Marianne, Wilson, Christy, Latoya, Cameron Hill, Renee Meir, and myself, Michelle Ross Williams. And I'm not seeing it though, but what we want to get from it when we're what transactional analysis is, to understand the history, the background of the technique, the therapeutic goals, the advantages and disadvantages of transactional analysis, to identify some variations of the technique, the applicability within the Caribbean and Jamaican context, and the training that needs to be actually going to be, as well as how transactional analysis can be used in the treatment. It's not moving on my screen though, Uncle Joe. I'm not sure what's happening.
Screen, it's moving.
Yes, it just started moving on. You need to press YouTube.
But we need
YouTube. YouTube button. Don't press the YouTube button. Just press my name. Press where my name is on. That's where my face would have been.
What are we talking about?
Are you seeing it on screen, Dr. Mac?
Yes, I am.
Okay, I'm seeing it. I clicked culture and it came up. Thanks.
Okay.
Marlene and Latoya, you're seeing it? And Renee?
Yes,
we're going to start off with the introduction of the transactional analysis. And each day we negotiate life with a myriad of interactions. And some are instantaneous, such as saying good morning to your coworkers, while others are negotiated, such as a request for a raise, which is a transaction of transactions. And they are the concerns of the transactional analysis. And further around, we'll be depicting that. Transactional analysis are a theory of personality and an organized system of interactional therapy. It is grounded on the assumption that we make current decisions based on our past premises and premises that were appropriate to our survival needs, but they are no longer valid. A main goal of transactional analysis with children and adolescents is to facilitate insight so that they are able to assume increased control of their thoughts, their feelings, and actions. And as children and adolescents develop this self-understanding, they always acquire the ability to make changes both within themselves and in their with others. Snapshot, just to hear how persons think about transactional analysis. It won't be long. It wouldn't be all of the, but I tell you when to stop, Kojo.
No, it's not. We won't be able to stop. I'll watch. Can somebody, you're going to have to watch it together. And you may have to watch
it
together.
It's all right. It's okay. I can go. I'll go on without it.
Can we watch it together? Can we click on it? What do we do?
Get the link to the right in the chat.
But we have to watch it together or individually. What we need
watch
to
it
do?
Together. Watch it together now, and I'll get the people on YouTube to watch it as well.
Okay, let me just say, once the this and I begin to talk about the school, then you can click off.
And somebody will signal me because I won't be watching it.
Okay. All right. So if the interviews are finished and I begin to talk about the school, you can just click off. Thanks.
Okay.
So we can click in now.
Do we have to click?
Click and start watching. Just click it in the right hand.
We have various challenges in our lives. We have stresses and strains and difficult situations. We can be really useful in helping us to deal with those things, to really empower us to make the change in our lives. And transactional analysis then is a really useful tool that we can use in counselling and psychotherapy to affect those changes and to help us not only in the therapy realm but outside. What I love about TA is basically the accessibility. The fact that I could come along knowing absolutely but immediately start to understand. It made perfect sense from day one.
It gives me a way for understanding me, understanding others, and then gives me a way of making changes or helping others make changes that will really stick.
What I like best about TA is the way it uses language. I find it a hugely useful tool in everyday life, as well as being a fantastic method of use within psychotherapy.
Well, the language is easy to understand, the tools and the models are really good to work with, and as soon as I discovered TA, it really dropped and it's made a big difference to my life. I love TA because it's given me a language to really express everything I felt inside, but never had words to really put around it, and the amount of personal development it's given me, the ability to help facilitate change and development in others as a career is going to be so rewarding and fantastic.
The teaching at the Link Centre is a whole range of different styles, really. So what we have is we have formal teaching, we have experiential exercises, and we also do practice of triad work of people being counsellors and practicing their
style. Once you get to the teaching session, you can click it off.